Highlights of the 86ers' first season in the Canadian Soccer League.
The Canadian Soccer League is a reality.
The 8-team Canadian Soccer League is born. A name from Vancouver's proud soccer past, Buzz Parsons was named the Vancouver 86ers' general manager. For the 86ers would be Burnaby Swongard Stadium, the perfect setting that seats over 5,000 and has one of the finest natural turf surfaces in the country. Another former Whitecap, Bob Lenarduzzi, runs his first training camp as player and coach, with Parsons wondering if the mix is right. One of the most popular Whitecaps of all time was sure to help. Carl Valentine's experience in the middle and on the flank was a welcome addition. The training camp revealed one thing. The 86ers were young. This was a league designed to develop Canadian soccer stars of the future, while at the same time providing players like Dominique Mobilio with a place to showcase their talents.
It was a great experience for me because I've always dreamed about being a professional soccer player, and when Vancouver came into the Canadian Soccer League, it gave me a chance to come and show, you know, play in front of my home crowd.
The big question facing the 86ers was crowds. Would Vancouver soccer fans support the team like they'd done not so long ago? The answer was a big yes, with an average attendance of close to 6,000 for 11 home games. By the end of the season, the fans knew what to expect, but in the beginning, the fans and their new coach weren't so sure.
I can remember the first game of the season, and I can remember being as nervous as I've ever been for a game. But I went out and was trying to play the game for 10 other guys, and realized that I didn't have to do it because they went out and put on a great show the first night and managed to get the people coming back for more after that.
It was only fitting that the 86ers' first ever goal would be scored by Carl Valentine. The fans loved it, and so did Valentine. The opposition for the 86ers in the season opener came from the Edmonton Brickmen. Ross Ongaro did his best to spoil the party, scoring with a rebound. The 86ers took the lead when the experience of Valentine came through with perfect execution from the penalty spot. The give and go gave Vancouver a two-goal margin. Ivor Evans to Jim Easton, back to Evans for the finish. Another combination gave the 86ers its final goal in the opener. Jamie Lowry sets up the first of 12 on the season for Dominique Mobilio. Vancouver wins his first game in the CSL 4-2. The second week in June, close to 8,000 jam Swongard to see what would become a familiar sight. Mobilio finding the back of the net from the penalty spot. Just like the Brickmen the week before, the Winnipeg Fury weren't about to roll over and play dead. Mike Conway converting a pass from Han Kim. Vancouver responded with a lesson on how to pass the ball. Easton to Lowry, to Guido Titoto, who returns the ball to Lowry for the perfect finish. The 86ers were off to a quick start, but after four games and losses to Winnipeg and Calgary, they were 2-2. In the fifth game of the season against Edmonton, Bob Lenarduzzi and Arnie Mears set up a goal for Mobilio. That was only the first for the member of Canada's under-19 youth team. Mobilio counts his second of the season from the penalty spot. The 86ers go in front 3-1 when Arnie Mears shows his superiority in the air, the perfect header. Edmonton close out the scoring with a goal from Norm Odinga. Vancouver win it 3-2. And after five games, have three wins and two losses. 4 days later, the 86ers are home to Calgary. Lindsey Henderson scores the first goal and then has one go in off his leg to even the game at one. This game belongs to Doug Muirhead. He comes on as a substitute in the 69th minute and takes a pass from Mobilio. Muirhead may not have had much time to warm up, but his scoring touch was red hot. Muirhead counts his second of the game, and this time it's Valentine who feeds him the pass. The substitute outraces the defender and curls a shot inside the post. The 86ers improve their record to 4-2 with a 3-1 victory. Game six saw the return of another Whitecap. Goalkeeper Tino Lettieri was back in town as a member of the Hamilton Steelers. Lettieri received a warm welcome from Jim Easton. The former member of Dundee United takes a centering pass from Mears, and even Ozzie the Parrot couldn't stop that one. Easton's second goal of three in this one is a beauty. He passes to Mears, who plays it back to Easton, who finds Valentine. Valentine, with a neat flick of the head, gives it back to Easton for the goal. Easton completes the hat trick with a goal that Tino is still looking for. He has plenty of time to set up and get off one of the hardest shots in the CSL. On July 21st, the Ottawa National Pioneers are enjoying a 1-0 lead over the 86ers at Swungard Stadium when Lowry beats a defender and passes to Mears. That ties the game at one. It's Mears who gives Vancouver the lead when he scores from a scramble. When Dominique Mobilio wasn't scoring goals, he was setting them up. Ivor Evans takes a Mobilio cross at the far post to give the 86ers a 3-1 victory. Vancouver close out the first half of the season against North York, and Mobilio scores his fifth of the year when he combines with Arnie Mears and Carl Valentine. A 2-0 win is just what the 86ers need. Vancouver plays seven of their next nine games on the road, and this 3-1 victory over the Brickmen in Edmonton is their only win. Jim Easton counts his sixth goal of the season, and after 18 games, the 86ers have won eight, lost seven, and tied three. On September 6th, the 86ers are at home to Winnipeg in a game dominated by Mobilio. He begins his hat trick by converting a pass from Muirhead. His eighth goal of the season is another well-taken penalty shot. Number nine is courtesy of Arnie Mears, who does most of the work, beating a couple of defenders before setting up Mobilio. It's 3-0, but the 86ers' most productive game of the season is not over. John Hughes crosses from the left side to Ivor Evans, and it's 4-1 Vancouver. Evans returns the favor when he chips the ball to a speeding Easton. Easton beats the defender for his seventh of the season. The second-place 86ers win it 5-1 and are playoff-bound with a record of 9 wins, 8 losses, and 3 ties. The one-game Western semifinal has the 86ers at home to Edmonton. Vancouver are expecting a tough game from the Brickmen and aren't disappointed. They take the lead when Mobilio sets up Easton. His rocket from 16 yards out is too hot to handle. Then with the game in the dying minutes, tied at one, a break for the 86ers. Keeper Wayne Gordy tries to clear, only to have Lowry headed back, and defender George Rodriguez knock the ball over the bar with his hand. That provides Dominique Mobilio with another chance to be a hero.
Bob asked me to take the penalty shot, and I was a little nervous, and I said, yeah, and I went up and put it down. And I just made sure I wanted to hit the net, and I hit the net and went in, and it was the biggest goal of my life. And if I knew if I missed, that we would have went into overtime, maybe possibly lost, but as soon as it went in,
I knew that I was going to win, and it was the greatest goal in my life.
In the Western Final against the Kickers in Calgary, it's Greg Kern who opens the scoring for the division winners. With the game tied at 3, Nick Gilbert heads home across, and the Kickers are final bound with a 4-3 victory. The season was over for the 86ers, with a tough loss to the eventual CSL champions. But Vancouver will return in 88, with a team that promises more of the same exciting soccer that thrilled almost 64,000 fans in the first year of operation. Professional soccer has been given a second chance by the Canadian Soccer League, and the Vancouver 86ers took full advantage of that opportunity and disappointed no one. Soccer, 86ers style, is alive and well. Pepsi and Canada Safeway, two proud sponsors of the Vancouver 86ers, have presented the highlights of the 86ers' first season in the Canadian Soccer League.